There has been, rather unfortunately, some debate as to whether or not Harriet Tubman is a good choice for the $20 bill. Again, a ridiculous debate. But if you do need convincing, then you should see Harriet, which makes a compelling and moving argument for why Harriet Tubman deserves not just to be on the 20, but to have her place in American history that she has been too long denied. I mean, wow, what an amazing historical figure. But it's also unfortunate that this movie itself has come under a lot of criticism, from the casting of a British actress as such a historic African-American figure, to giving Harriet superpowers, right? To, well, the petty list seems to go on and on. Look, see this movie. I cannot recommend it highly enough. And as for some of those criticisms, I want to address them here. But no spoilers. First off, Cynthia Erivo, as she has done in every role I've seen her in to date, does an impressive job. Her portrayal of Harriet is powerful and real, instead of Hollywoodizing Harriet Tubman, as Hollywood so often does with historical figures, particularly female ones. And yes, Harriet Tubman had visions, but that's not something the movie cooked up to compete with the superhero movies of today. She really did! And while there are probably real-life explanations for what Harriet Tubman experienced, from gut instincts to simply vivid dreams, she did suffer a severe head injury as a child, as the movie also covers, to maybe she genuinely had some psychic insight. I know a person who I trust deeply who's seen things that just can't be explained throughout her life. But also, to be quite frank, back in the mid-1880s, that's how a deeply religious woman would view such things as signs from God. And who are we to judge what gives someone strength, which allows them to not only do good for themselves, but so many others? Also, again, it really happened. Harriet Tubman was famous for a lot of things, and one of them was for these, you know, signs from God that she said she had. So, of course, the movie's going to depict it. Something else that really happened, which this movie only touches on at the end, and you should know about whether you see this movie or not, which is why this is the one thing that I'm going to bring up. But it covers the fact that Harriet Tubman was the first woman to lead an armed military assault during the Civil War, and remains, to this day, one of the few women in the United States to ever, and I think in the world, have ever led a military assault. How cool is that, and why am I only hearing about it now? Now, sure, actress-turned-to-director Kasi Lemmons has made a few films that are a bit Tyler Perry-esque, right? And there's nothing wrong with that. I enjoy Tyler Perry films as well. But this, of course, is supposed to be a more serious subject matter. But I think she appropriately has significantly leveled up for this movie. Making a movie, and it feels like a movie, by the way. It doesn't feel like a TV movie. It doesn't feel like a streaming show. It feels like a movie. And I think that it plays like the best historic novels that is accessible to all ages. I think anyone would enjoy this movie, Harriet, but it's certainly a movie that children can and should see. I imagine this movie will have a very long life being played in schools, I hope across the globe. It's very, very good. And not only does it do a good job depicting Harriet Tubman and telling her story, but it also offers a nuanced and unflinching look at slavery as a whole, conveying an extraordinary amount of information in just 2 hours. Again, as to the overall situation for African Americans in the South and the North. And I think it touches on a lot of the emotional beats, but also a lot of the historic things that happened. It's very, very strong. And in addition to Erivo's touching lead performance, the entire cast does a wonderful job. Leslie Odom Jr. and Janelle Monae, two incredibly charismatic actors, they are excellent as free African Americans Harriet meets in the North. And Monae, while her role is small, has some very strong moments here. Clark Peters and Vanessa Bell Calloway are very moving as Harriet's parents. And in fact, Harriet's entire relationship with her whole family is very, very touching. And it's wonderful, something also rare in Hollywood, to see a family, such a loving family on screen, whose love and support for each other keeps them going in such a monstrous situation. I thought that was wonderful. There's a lot to relate to even today, to things that happen in this movie. I thought both for feminism with Harriet and also, you know, with the way the family is depicted here. I thought it was great. Henry Hunter Hall is also very charismatic, not as well known as Odom Jr. and Monet, but really good. He really leapt off the screen in a surprisingly nuanced and I would say frank role. Not all African Americans were necessarily as saintly as Harriet at that time. He had a great role and I loved his outfit. All right. Also, unfortunately, though, one of the weak links in the film is Joe Alwyn. And I did get a hoot out of the fact that Taylor Swift is dating a slave owner. I was like, wow. But he didn't even do a good job. I mean, if you're going to play the slave owner in the movie, you should at least kill it. You should do an amazing job. I mean, he didn't do anything with the villain. I mean, I know he's playing a villainous role, but it doesn't mean he couldn't bring something to the table. I mean, this is an opportunity actors like Alan Rickman wouldn't have wasted, and that Michael Fassbender and Leonardo DiCaprio did not. Quite frankly, I can't recommend Harriet strongly enough. I was moved to tears several times watching this movie. It's very good, and I think it belongs up there with films like Glory, Lincoln, and even Gone with the Wind, you know, which of course has a horrible depiction of slavery, but it did win the first Oscar for a black actor or actress for Hattie McDaniel. But still, that offers, I think, a complete picture of Hollywood's depiction of the Civil War and the different perspectives. But, you know, you shouldn't watch just some of those films. You need to watch all of them. And there are, of course, also many powerful stories out of Hollywood about slavery. And Harriet definitely deserves a place in that group as well. So that's my review for Harriet. I really hope that you see it. Share your thoughts down below. Subscribe today. And, of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.